and they talk about me up by the grown men. I have a wife and two children over there. This will be the last day I get to set my eyes on them. This will probably be the last day I get to see my beautiful wife again. I will have to be sold up to my master, probably for the rest of my life. I know he's going through something. Where's they take me when they call an old friend? I'll take care of some of the men's house, tend some of the men's fields, and making sure some of the men's kids get fed. That's Robbie.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, here on display, we have a new slate that's up for taking. I'll take questions before we start the bidding.
How much does this boy weigh?
I'll say he's well around 25 pounds at least.
How much can you lift, boy?
Go ahead and tell me, boy.
Show us your arms and all your muscles, boy.
Is this boy a hard worker?
I'll say he's a fairly hard worker.
Turn around again, boy.
Okay, let's settle down and let's begin the bidding at $25.
25.
I got 25, how about 30?
$30. 40.
Hey, better now. I got 40, do I hear 50?
$70, I want to take this boy home. 95.
Well, I don't believe it. This boy here is about to go for $100. I got 95. Do I hear 100? Going once, going twice. So, bring that boy to that man over there.
Why won't they let me touch him? Let me and my kids say goodbye. I have to raise these two on my own now. What am I gonna do? These kids get scared sometimes at night, and they done just took their daddy away. Took him, sold him, called him a boy. My husband ain't no boy, he a man, and they took him away from us forever.
Why are they always looking at me like that? Like they think I'm better than them, just because I'm serving instead of working in the field. But I'm just as much a slave as they are. In fact, sometimes I think life is worse for me. I don't fit in with the field slaves, and I feel like a stepchild in the house. Sometimes they treat me real good, but other times, most times, I feel real lonely. No one to talk to, no one to cry with, be all alone.
All right, we worked in fields, and for what? We ain't got none. My kids ain't got none, my wife ain't got none. How am I supposed to feel like a man when I ain't got none? Sometimes my wife should be so happy. She may want her pretty dresses, you know, be just as proud. Look just as pretty as she want to be. But soon enough, all the smiles and all the good time feelings be done and going away. And her pretty dresses end up being work clothes. It shows how I watch my wife work like so.
All right, y'all, get back to work.
riding the bus home today as usual. Oh, how my feet was aching. I took the closest seat I could find. At the next stop, a white young man was picked up and couldn't find an empty seat anywhere in front. I guess he wasn't about to sit in the back of all them black folks, so I was told to give my seat to him. I'm actually gonna do no such thing. Tired as I was, I'm attached to the seat just as anybody else is, so I refuse to give it up. Now I'm being arrested and taken to jail for standing for throwing a rock. Y'all keep on keeping on.
No seats, no service, no seats, no service, no seats, no service.
This diner is right down the street from my house, but I have to walk 7 more blocks to a black-owned diner where I can be served and seated. I know that slavery is over and we're supposed to be free and all. Sometimes it just doesn't feel like it.
No seats, no service, no seats, no service.
I refuse to be told to pick up my food at the back of the restaurant. You can take my money, but I can't take a seat in your restaurant. Me and my people, we just ain't going for that anymore. Loud enough, they can't hear you.
No seats, no service, no seats, no service.
I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream that one day even the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of injustice, sweltering with the heat of oppression, will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream that my 4 little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today!
Because people found it difficult to pronounce. Later, as I began teaching at Harvard University and taking care of my 2 children, I managed to write my first novel called The Blue Star. I hope to continue writing prize piece literature for years to come.
My name is Colin Pop. I was nominated by President Bush on December 16, 2000 as Secretary of State. I was born in New York, educated by public schools, and graduated in the City College of New York. I participated in ROTC and graduated in June of 1958. I have received numerous U.S. and foreign military awards and many civilian awards as well. I've been proud and honored to serve my country.
Hello, my name is Barack Obama. You might remember me from the 2004 Democratic National Convention. I delivered the keynote address. I was born in Honolulu, Hawaii. I both my parents were attending the University of Hawaii. My name Barak means blessed in Swahili, as I feel I am. I grew up most of my life there in Hawaii, and later attended college in California. After graduating from Columbia University, I worked for a newsletter publisher and then moved to Chicago and got involved in community organizing on Chicago's South Side. Then I went back to school at Harvard University and studied law and became the first Black president of the Harvard Law Review. Then I became a law professor at Harvard University, and today, because of lots of hard work and determination, I am now Senator of the great state of Illinois.
Hi, my name is Oprah Winfrey. How have you watched my show? I began a career broadcasting as a result of learning to perform recitals at the age of 13. My broadcasting career began at the age of 17 when I was hired at WVOO radio station in Nashville. 2 years later, I was signed to WTVF-TV as a recording anchor. Today, I am named as one of the most influential people of the 20th century by Time magazine. I also received a Lifetime Achievement Award. Because I have been so blessed today, my Angel Network is presenting me with $100,000 to award people who are using lives to improve the lives of others. Thank you, and have a nice day.
Hi, I'm Jackie Robinson. You might have seen me if you have visited the Baseball Hall of Fame in the state of New York. Being in the Baseball Hall of Fame might not seem such a big deal to you, but when I was inducted to play in the Major Leagues, it was a major deal. During 1947, the Brooklyn Dodgers president, Grant Trinke, asked me to play in the Major Leagues and be on his team. Baseball had been a segregated sport for over 50 years, but who was I to change that? But I did. It took lots of courage to withstand all the humiliating and degrading remarks and treatment I received, but I was determined to stick it out. Today, many Blacks have earned many opportunities to play in their major leagues and their own counterparts. So everyone, let's play ball!
In Time of Silver Rain. In time of silver rain, the earth puts forth new life again. Green grasses grow and flowers lift their heads. And over all the plain, the wonder spreads of life, of life, of life. In time of silver rain, the butterflies have silken wings to catch a rainbow crab. And trees put forth new leaves to sing and joy beneath the sky. As down the roadway, passing boys and girls go singing too. In time of silver rain, when spring and life are near.
As new Vice President of the United States, I would just like to say thank you.
Woo!
Without further ado, I would just like to welcome the new 2012 President of the United States of America, the person you voted to lead our country in uprightness and all honesty, abiding in the law to provide a better place for all U.S. citizens alike. My friend, your Congressman, President Loretta Ann Johnson.
Woo!
It won't be easy.
It may not happen as quickly as you wanted to, but America, as you stood up for me, as you demanded a change in our great country, I intend to stand for and with you. It's time for change, and I'm just delighted to do it.
Leaning on the everlasting arms. enjoyed it. Did you guys enjoy it? We worked extremely hard on that, and we welcome any of you back to the 6:30 p.m. show. We just welcome you back, or to tell people about it, because we work extremely hard, and we want everyone to be able to enjoy that. So, thank you.
On behalf of the Roosevelt students and staff, we'd like to thank Mrs. Scarley, the principal of Call, and Mr. Lumen for giving up his gymnasium. Thank you for making this all possible.